गुड मॉर्निंग क्लास फिफ्थ, दिस इज मी रत्ना मुखर्जी, सब्जेक्ट टीचर ऑफ SST सब्जेक्ट, एंड टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू एक्सप्लेन चैप्टर नंबर 4, हिस्ट्री ऑफ राइटिंग, द इम्पॉर्टेंस ऑफ राइटिंग एंड हिस्ट्री ऑफ राइटिंग. सो दिस इज द स्मॉल स्टोरी. आई वॉज ट्रेवलिंग इन द मेट्रो ट्रेन द अदर डे when the lady sitting next to me got up and a young boy came and sat beside me. He looked at me for a while as if trying to start a conversation. I asked him what he wanted. He did not speak, only raised his eyebrows. I asked again, only to realize that he could not speak. He was hearing and speech impaired. I got anxious. How will I communicate with him? I don't even know sign language. Meanwhile, he took out a small notepad from his pocket and wrote on it, "What station do I get off for Knott Place?" I felt so stupid. I smiled and wrote back on his notepad. The world would not be the way it is if human beings did not have the ability to communicate, to organize themselves and to pass on knowledge from generation to generation. So now we have to learn what is language. Language is a system of communication in which voice, sound, gesture, symbol, etc. are used. Language is necessary to express inner thoughts and emotions, to fulfill our wants and need, to establish, rule and maintain our culture. Alright students, so what was the meaning of language? Language is a system of communication in which voice, sound, gesture, symbols, etc. are used. Alright. Open page number 32. During prehistoric times, people used to communicate orally using gestures and signals, but information could only be passed to a few people. That means only a few people understand well. The difficulty in comprehension also led to problem in recollection of information. This led to loss of information while it was passed on to future generation. Hence, the need to record information led to the discovery of writing. That means these all type of problem discovered a writing. Alright, this is the painting of cave painting, and this is a hieroglyphic picture. Alright, this is a hieroglyphic picture. I explained already in our live classes. Written communication. The earliest form of written communication was through pictures, glyphs. That means simplified pictures, directly represented objects and concepts that were used. Early human drew pictures mostly of animals and things that they saw around them on the cave walls. Soon, pictures were replaced by symbols called hieroglyph. It comprised simple drawings which were used to depict the actual object. However, they had to be agreed upon by the society for everyone to understand. Thus, the script came into existence. Alright, that means if they draw some type of comb or leaf, that means one. If they draw some type of pictorial pictures, that means two. If they draw some type of birds picture, that means three. So they indicate the animals and things to indicate some type of letters and numbers. Alright. A script is a system of writing that consists of symbol, hieroglyphic, ideograms, mnemonics, etc., commonly agreed upon by the society. This is the picture of cuneiform script. I explained already in our live classes. People living in southern Mesopotamia developed one of the earliest script in the world. The writing system began with symbol being drawn on clay tablets. They used clay on that time. Using a sharp edged knife, where the characters were usually wedge-shaped and the script was known as the cuneiform script. Cuneiform was also used by some of the neighboring countries of Mesopotamia, namely Persians and Hittites. In ancient Egypt, people used to communicate through hieroglyphs. All right? Means this type of hieroglyphic pictorial picture, they communicated each other. Now, open page number 33. This is the picture of Brahmi script. I have explained already. So, however, these signs and symbols change over the year. There are still countries like China, Japan and Korea. They are pictorial script. That use pictorial script. These scripts are different to read, write and understand. Most languages use a system of alphabets. An alphabet is a standard set of letters and symbols which are used to write a language. The letter of the alphabet represent the basic significant sound of the spoken language. The English language is written in the Roman alphabet, which consists of 26 letters. Alright, student. In India, the earliest form of writing was discovered on seals. I also show you on seals pictures and Indus Valley civilizations picture. Belonging to the Indus Valley civilization, seals were made of clay, terracotta, copper, etc. and had inscriptions in pictorial writing on them. One of the oldest writing system that emerged in India during that time was the Brahmi script. The best known Brahmi inscriptions are the rock cut edicts of Ashoka in north central India. Script of many Indian languages have been developed from the ancient Brahmi script. For example, the Devanagari script is used for writing Hindi, one of the official languages of India. Alright, see this, Brahmi script was deciphered in 1837 by James Prinsep, an archaeologist, philologist and official of the East India Company. Now our next topic is numbers, and this is the picture of early symbol used for counting, like this 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 10, 20, 30, etc. Counting of objects began all over the world many years ago. Even early humans felt the need of counting the number of animals they had hunted. Alright, that means the concept of zero and decimal system were also introduced to the world by Indian scholars. The Arab adopted the Indian numerals and called them Hindse. That means from India. Meaning from India. Alright, let's pick the next topic, that is paper. This is the picture of papyrus, early writing on papyrus. Alright. As man learned to read, write and count, he felt the need to record the information. For this, he needed a flat surface. In ancient time, he used clay tablet, big leaves and the bark of certain trees. The Egyptians were the first to make paper from a reed called papyrus. The word paper is derived from papyrus. Later, the Chinese found that paper could also be made by pounding together rags, ropes or old finishing nets into pulp. Alright, this art of making paper spread to other parts of the world through different material were used in different places. Scientists worked with other raw materials and were able to make paper from wood pulp and vegetable pulp as we use today. Alright, so this is the picture of early writing on papyrus. Alright, here in 1798, Nicholas Louis Robert invented the first machine to produce continuous roll instead of sheet of paper. Today, paper is used all over the world, and hence its production is increasing on a larger scale. All right. So this was the explanation of paper. Now let's pick the next topic, that is printing and its advantage. Printing. Jonas Gutenberg's press. This is the picture of Johannes Gutenberg's press. Printing is process used for reproducing text and image, typically with ink, which may be black or colored, on paper using a printing press. It is used not only for books, magazine and newspaper, but also for packaging, wallpaper, textile, etc. Let's read our next topic. The first printing press was invented by Johannes Gutenberg of Germany around 1940. The Bible was the first book to be printed. It is popularly known as the Gutenberg's Bible. All right, I have already explained in live classes. So, how does the printing press work? Type or small metal letters that have a raised letter on each end are arranged on papers and placed into a frame. Ink is spread out evenly on these letters. A damp piece of paper is taken as this lets the type bite into the paper better. The paper is held on a flat metal plate and the type is pressed on to make an impression. Now, let's pick the next topic, that is books for the visually impaired. This is the picture of Braille script. I have already explained in live classes and showed the picture already. The Braille system is a method that is widely used by the visually impaired people. Impaired means disability, all right, or damage anything. For reading and writing, it is named after a visually impaired Frenchman, Louis Braille, who invented this script. All right. Now the last topic, that is literacy and program. Literacy and program. Let's pick the next topic, last topic of chapter 4. Literacy and program. Literacy and program go hand in hand. A nation cannot progress if its people are literate. Yes, nation cannot be progress if we are literate. Hence, literacy can help in the development and progress of a nation. Literacy helps in removing poverty. However, in India, a large number of people are still illiterate. This is one of the main reasons that a large population of India is poverty ridden. The government is now taking a step to promote education in our society. Free education is given to the poor and adult education programs are being encouraged, especially in the rural areas. Alright, so this was the explanation of chapter number 4, History of Writing. Students, I have already explained all the topic with detail, with photographs in our live classes. But still, you have to read page number 31, 32, 33, 34 and 35. And if you have any doubt regarding chapter 4, History of Writing, then please contact me or message me. I will solve your problem. Tomorrow, I will send all the book exercise, difficult words and keywords, that means glossary, and question answer, both all together on your School Mitra app. All right? Stay happy, stay fit and enjoy your holidays finally. After 2 days, thank you very much. Have a good day.